Hello, my name is Niamh, I'm from Breakthrough Maths, and welcome to this video on how to prove cos A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. Okay, this proof is going to make use of the following fact, okay? That cos theta is equal to cos of minus theta. What I mean is that cos of any positive angle is equal to the cos of the minus of that angle, okay? Another rule that we're going to use is that sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. Now, in a lot of trigonometric proofs, these are really, really important rules, and I just want to take the opportunity now in this video to show you actually why this is true. Okay, let's just take a minute and have a look here. So on the left-hand side here, we have a sine graph. Nope, wrong. We have a cos graph. Y equals cos theta. On the right hand side here, we have our sine graph. Okay, let's just focus on this cos graph for a minute. I want to draw your attention to, if I just draw a vertical line here along the y-axis, okay, what we can see straight away is that this graph is exactly symmetrical through that y-axis, right? Imagine my two hands, this is one side of the graph, this is another side of the graph. If I was to fold this graph on top of itself, it would exactly match up. It is exactly symmetric through the y-axis. What is the mathematical significance of this? Well, let's have a look. Let's say I want to know what cos of 180 degrees is, for example. Okay, let's just look at that. Then we're going to draw a dotted line down to our graph, and we're going to see where I end up. And so we end up at about minus 1. So we find out, okay, cos of 180 is equal to minus 1. But now, let's look at if we look at cos of minus 180 degrees. So minus 180 degrees is about here. And we do the same thing, dot, 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 across our y-axis. And again, we end up at minus 1, guys. So the cos of a negative angle is exactly equal to the cos of the positive of that angle because of this symmetry. Okay, now draw your attention to the y equals sine theta graph. Little bit different this time. Again, I'm going to draw a vertical line through the y-axis here. And what we'll see this time is that through the y-axis, the graph is vertically flipped. Okay, one side of the graph is like this, the other side is like that. Let's look at the mathematical significance of this. Let's say we're looking at sine 90. And we're going to go dot, 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 we're going to go across the y-axis. And what we find is that sine of 90 is equal to 1, reading it straight off the graph. Let's do the same thing for minus 90. Minus 90 is about here. And we're going to read it off the graph. And we find that sine of minus 90 is equal to minus 1. Okay. So that this anti-symmetry in the sine theta graph is the reason that we have sine theta minus sine theta is equal to sine of minus theta. Okay, we're going to make a lot of use of this property in a lot of trigonometric proofs. Okay, so first step in this proof is to write down our formula straight from the log tables for cos of A minus B this time. And cos of A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. Now, I'd like to go through and I'd like to replace everywhere I see a B with minus B. There's no problem in doing this. It's like arbitrary labeling. Okay, you can label as anything you want. If we call it minus B instead of B, it shouldn't change our formula in any way. So we're allowed to do that. So let's go. So it's going to be cos of A minus minus B. Double minus here. Be careful with that. We've got a cos A cos of minus B plus sine A sine of minus B. Now, cos of A minus minus B, if you've got two minuses, it becomes a plus, becomes cos A plus B. This is equal to cos A. Now we said that cos of a minus angle is the same as cos of the same angle. So cos minus B becomes cos B. We said that the sine of a minus angle because minus sine of that angle. So we end up with sine A minus sine B. So this plus here becomes a minus. And we're left with cos A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. And we've proved it in just a few lines.